So where does one begin to improve the consistency across all of your digital communications within your enterprise? The very first step is to audit what you're currently sending. Literally get every single message, every email template that's being sent out to your customers and put them up on a wall or a screen. You're going to end up with a very large amount of messages, whether it's onboarding, newsletters, welcomes, bills, confirmations, updates to T&Cs, password reset confirmations, and the list goes on and on and on. Only once you do this audit and you look at all of these types of communications as a whole, will you realize certain things such as, are we addressing the customer in the same fashion? Do we use their name or do we say dear customer? Why are we using different salutations? Is the tone the same across all email types or do we change each tone for each message type? Should we be doing that? Do these all look like they're coming from the same company? Now, as you go down this path, you're going to make many insights. Some of those insights are going to be, wow, we really need to change these messages. We need to align them. We need to remove the fractures. And some of those other insights are, wow, we really have a big gap here in the customer journey. Now, once you've done that audit, which is the most important and very first step, now where do you begin making changes? You have to first examine your customer touch points. So those existing touch points, those existing messages that are being sent out, look at them and identify which ones are the most regularly occurring. More often than not, you're going to find that these are those that reside in that sort of billing and payment related area. That's because we all know billing statements, account summary communications, all of those go out pretty regularly, whether they're monthly or semi-monthly. The other instance of communications that go out very regularly is going to be your marketing. So these are the two journeys where we would suggest you look at first. You want to touch those that are most regularly occurring, going out to your customers on a consistent basis. And what should you do with those? Well, you want to enhance those and remove any existing digital fractures. So look to improve what you're currently sending. So that means mapping out that journey with all of those communications and making them consistent across the board. So making sure the tone is all the same, that the look and feel is all the same, that the type of content that you're talking about is relevant. Small tweaks here and there to individual email types will help you as you put the larger policies, the larger systems and processes in place within your enterprise. The key is not to wait until everything is in line. Instead, the key is to start somewhere and to start now. So once you've looked at your existing communications, then now you're going to see those gaps within the customer journey. And the way you do this is you need to ask very critical questions about the communications that you're currently sending out. That means you need to look left, you need to look right at the communications that come before and after each other, and then expand outwards. What should come next? What is missing? What could the customer possibly want to hear from us about in this particular journey? Ask yourselves those questions, and you're going to see there are going to be gaps within the journey. And these gaps are where you can find quick wins by instituting those communications and aligning them with the rest of the communications that you're sending out. Now, while you're doing this, you want to make sure that all the content across all of your emails, all of your messages is relevant. So what do we mean by this? Well, the landscape, the world that we live in has evolved. But unfortunately, our practices and our communications really have not. The only thing that's remained constant over time is the channel, right? Most of us are communicating with our customers via email. Well, ask yourself, when you've done that audit, are all of these communications relevant to our customer? Do we know the customer enough to send them targeted, relevant info? A perfect example is that of someone who has renter's insurance in New York City. Would it make sense to send them a marketing campaign related to auto insurance? Probably not, because most people who rent in New York City don't have an automobile. So in that instance, that customer is going to be tuned out to the message that you've sent them and more likely not to pay attention to your future communications with them. So ensure your content is relevant and finding ways to understand your customer so that you can match up the message with them is key. Now, all of this can't be done in a silo. It can't be done by one person or a group within one department. Rather, you need to work with a team. You just cannot affect change alone. But instead, you've got to get a cross-functional group together that consists of operations, marketers, IT, analytics, customer voice professionals, and even more dependent upon your enterprise. Only once you all work together to audit and determine your path forward can you have the confidence needed that you as a team can implement these changes that will truly enhance the experience through your digital communications and therefore provide an experience to your customers that is 100% fracture free. By starting now to think about this and to align your customer communications, you'll be on the road to a better customer experience, more engagement from your customers, loyalty, and most importantly, you'll provide the consistency and you'll eliminate those digital fractures that current customers are experiencing. We hope you found this quick, easy 6-step process beneficial today. We're always available should you need assistance or advice. Please feel free to reach out.